So tell us about what dynamic parallelism adds to the CUDA programming model.
So quite simply, it lets you launch kernels directly from inside another kernel. And that sounds relatively simple. If you like, the analogy on the CPU side is when I could create threads inside a process. Instead of having to go back to the operating system to initiate a new process, I could suddenly spawn a pthread and do something asynchronously within the single process that I have, manage that all from within my own process. I can now do that on the GPU as well. I can create work, and not just single threads, I create whole grids from inside of my GPU. So if my problem is working on something and I suddenly need to invert a matrix or perform a Fourier transform or something, I can suddenly just call out into a kernel which does that for me, returns the data, and I can continue. So I can embed parallel work exactly where I need it with the data that I have available inside my program. Sort of corollary to that is this idea of being able to take data that dynamically you are working on, a value that you have a sort of mathematically, algorithmically generated, and use that value to make decisions on work you're going to do. So if my value is 1, do this, if it's 2, do that. Or maybe I am partitioning a problem, I'm building a tree, spatially partitioning something. If I have a certain number of things in one place, a larger number in another place, I can dynamically launch the correct number of threads to do that. And the ability to do this on the fly dynamically is really the power of this dynamic parallelism.